now in turns. You may have so many questions in your mind, like what to prepare, how to prepare, when to prepare, and the biggest question mark is why to prepare. All of these questions will be answered in the subsequent lectures in this PG orientation program. And I think you people are lucky enough to have such a guiding institute and teachers like Pustake sir, who are taking the efforts for this orientation program. Today, I'm going to cover the topic of the MDS entrance examination, means their exam patterns, important dates, events, and the eligibility criteria and the syllabus. Before that, I would like to share my experience of exam preparation, that is the entrance exam preparation. In 2016, I passed my final year and then I started preparation for the exam in the starting of the internship. But I want to tell you here that when I was in first BDS, then only I realized that I should do MDS in some subject. At that time, I was not aware about the subjects at all. Then in first BDS only I started to prepare for the exam. It's not like that I was solving so many MCQ books, but I was going through some MCQ books like Dental Pulse at the time of my first, second, third, and final year. So I think those who are now in second year, third year, they can solve MCQ books from now only, so that they can get an idea how to which type of questions they have to face in the final NEET exam or any entrance exam. And also in our university pattern, we have 20 marks MCQ. So it can also help you there. So I think when I was preparing for this entrance exam in my internship period, so it was a wonderful time when because I was so focused about the exam and I knew what I want to achieve and where I want to be in the future. So, my dear friend, those who are in the internship now, it is the most precious time you have to decide and prepare for your goal. Because now in internship, you do not have any college exam related stress, no deadline to submit any work. You just have to apply your theoretical knowledge in the clinical format. So you can decide your pace of study, the way of preparation, and also you will be your own boss. Like there is no one to tell you something like you have to submit this and that. So you have to sail your own boat to reach your destination. Here we are there to guide you, to tell you some direction. But you have to sail your boat. In this journey, what I feel the most important thing is the focus. Focus means follow one course until success. Means it is not uncommon for the student to lose the interest after a point. This causes many to lose the track for MDS preparation after 5-6 months. And by the time they realize this, most precious time has been lost. So I think to avoid this, make sure that you do not entirely give up on your hobbies and also refrain from overindulging in them. So this good timetable, I think it will help you a lot. So planning is also a very important thing in this. You should prepare your timetable for a week or suppose for a month. And allot sufficient time to some specific subjects. And make a list of things you want to read till the last month of the exam. So this is all will be helpful for the students, those who are now in internship. Make some changes in your timetable so that it will not get monotonous to you. Change your timetable after every month. And the third thing that is, I feel, most important is the group discussion. Means now you are so techno savvy people are. If you discuss amongst yourself, or you can make a healthy WhatsApp group and study. So discuss your doubts with your friends in the WhatsApp or mobile or anything. So it will help you a lot. If you discuss something there, that memory will last long. So it also may help you. I'm telling all these points briefly because all these things are going to be covered in the next subsequent lectures also. The next thing is notes, means the revision notes that I feel you should prepare from the starting of your entrance preparation. Means when you are after first reading, you should start preparing the notes so that it will help you to assess the important and the tough points that you are feeling, or you are feeling some points are difficult to remember. Then you can make the notes of those things, and so you can assess them easily when you are traveling or you are free in the college. So rather than carrying those heavy books, you can carry easily the notes and read them. Then the fourth thing is revision. You know, practice makes perfect. So to retain the facts and figures and to be able to recollect them on the exam day, you must revise the entire syllabus. It's not like that you should revise the things after for 6 times, 7 times. It's not like that. It's depend upon individuals, individuals' capability, IQ level, and the interest in the study. So you should all can decide those things. And the last thing I feel is the online education. There are so many online courses or online web series available. Now our college is taking the mock test. So you can easily apply or go through this test, and you can improve your knowledge in that. So this is the study. Here you can make the timetable, notes, online education, and a group discussion. So I think this is the roadmap to reach to the success. First thing is start. You should starting is most important, because it's always said that always better let to start than never. So if the final year students, I feel ki in the final year is the best time to start for entrance examination, because you already are preparing for the 8 subjects, and so you have so many knowledge about the clinical subjects in final year. But if now the final year is over, but don't worry, you can start now. Your internship is going to be start in this month. So, and after starting, think over it, what you want to achieve, what is your goal, think over it, plan for it, and then execute the things, then the success will be yours. So now we will move to our main topic, that is different MTS entrance examinations that you have to apply for to take the admissions in different government and the central institute and the private colleges and the universities. There are two exams, that is Institute of National Importance Combined Entrance Test and National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test, that is NEET MDS. This Institute of National Importance Combined Entrance Test, that is INICT, this is being conducted for the first time in 2022. Means at my time, there was AIIMS exam that was conducted by the All India Institute of Medical Science, Delhi, for taking admission in different AIIMS colleges like AIIMS Delhi, AIIMS Raipur, or AIIMS Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, and PGIMER was conducting its own exam to take admission in PGI Chandigarh. But now from 2022, this INICET is being conducted to take admission in all these institutes, like all the AIIMS colleges and PGI MER Chandigarh, NIMHANS Bangalore and JIPMER Pondicherry. So you do not have to apply separately for AIIMS exam and PGI exam. The official website is aimsexams.org, where you can get all the information regarding this exam, its exam patterns, syllabus, eligibility criteria, qualification, which is required, marking scheme. Here I am giving some highlights regarding the INICET exam. Name of the examination is Institute of National Importance Combined Entrance Test. It is known as INICET. Competent authority is All India Institute of Medical Science, Delhi. Institutes are Rishikesh, JIPMER Pondicherry, and PGI MER Chandigarh. Number of the test cities is 64, means from 64 centers you can apply, you can give your online exam. Level of the examination postgraduate and mode of examination is online. It's a computer based exam. Duration is 3 hours and frequency of the examination is biannual. That is January and the July session. Means for this January 2021 session, exam was conducted on 20th November 2020 and for July 2021 session, exam will be conducted in May 2021. Number of the questions, 200 questions with 5 alternatives and single correct choice or multiple correct choice questions. Marking scheme, negative marking, percentile best score will be used for deciding the overall rank of the candidate. Negative marking is where is 25% means 1/4 negative marking is there. Minimum percentile cutoff is 15th percentile, means you have you should get 15th percentile minimum to apply for the rounds. Age limit, there is no age limit. Minimal qualification means BDS degree from the recognized institute. You have to complete your 1 year compulsory rotary internship before 31st December for January session and 13th June for July session. Minimal marks for qualifying examination, OBC or general 55%, SC or ST 50%, means in final year, you should have this minimum marks to fill the forms for this entrance exam. Important dates and events. This I am telling you about regarding the INICET 2021. Those who started their internship now in this month of December will going to appear for the exam in 2022. Means INICET 2022, their exam will be in the month of November 2021. The basic registration starts in month of September to October, so that you will get an idea in which month the process start and the exam date is. Exam date was 20th November 2020. Result announced in 28th November. This is the process map. That is the application. The first step is you have to apply first, then the examination, and the last step is seat allocation. In the application, you have to do the basic registration. You will get a registration unique code, the final registration, the exam fees, and then examination at the time, 7 days before the exam, you will admit card, then computer based test, then declaration of the result, and preference form filling. Then the seat allocation, that is the rounds, will start subsequently. Seat matrix. This is the seat matrix for January 2021 session. That is in AIIMS Delhi, there were total 12 seats for cons, ortho, oral surgery, prostho, and pediatric dentistry. In AIIMS Patna, there are 3 seats, and in Raipur 1 and Rishikesh 1. This all information is there in the brochure also that I have told you the website. These all things are there in their brochure. This is the second test that is all are looking for the national eligibility cum entrance test. Most of the people think that they just want to give AIIMS exam just because they want to practice. Means they think that I want to just do the practice so that I can perform better in NEET. But I think it was also my attitude. But I think you should not think like that. Your attitude should be different. You should prepare for the AIIMS as you are preparing for the NEET exam. Most of the people thinking AIIMS exam, it's not in my cup of tea, but it's not like that. I think you should also try to get seat in AIIMS exam. This NEET exam has an official website, that is www.nbe.edu.in. NEET NDS is going to be conducted by the National Board of Examination for admission to various MDS courses in academic session 2021, which will include the following, that is government, all private dental institute and the universities all across the country, and MDS courses at Armed Force Medical Service Institute. Important, that means you will be aware about that this exam was conducted on the last week only, December 16. Application forms, you have to fill the applications form in the month of October. The declaration of the result, it will be, I think, declared on the 31st December. It is mentioned in the brochure. And choice filling and the locking process start in the second week of March. Eligibility criteria, there is no age limit. Qualification, BDS degree for recognized institute, completion of 1 year compulsory rotary internship. Candidate who is undergoing the 12-month compulsory rotary internship and is likely to complete the same by 31st March 2021. Means for those who are going to appear for the next NEET exam, that is NEET MDS 2021, for those people, the criteria will be like that. Means they have to complete their internship by 31st March 2022 and take up the examination. But he or she shall not be eligible for the admission unless he or she has completed the compulsory rotary internship and obtained a provisional or the permanent registration before 31st March 2021. Means before taking the admission, you should have your permanent or the provisional internship completion registration certificate, so that you only after that you can you are eligible for the exam. Mode of examination is online, that is the computer based test. Number of questions are 240. Marking scheme is negative marking. Means for correct response, there are 4 marks. And for incorrect response, the 1 mark shall be deducted. Unattempted questions, 0. This marks will be 0. Time is 3 hours. During the examination, candidates are given an option to mark any question, means whether attempted or not, is for review. Which means that candidate has been able to opt for that, means option to go through these questions again before the examination time ends. Means candidates may note that such questions which are marked for review shall be evaluated as per the marking scheme mentioned above. Means you have an option there to review your answer after the, some people think that sometimes you have doubt about the question. then you can mark that question as a review so that you can for after before the examination time gets over, you can review that choice, you can change your answer, and if you are failed to change the answer, then that answer will be considered as per the marking scheme. Syllabus for the MDS, this entrance exam, it's as per the DCI guideline. They have decided, they have divided the question paper in two parts. Part one is for 100 marks and part two is for 140 marks. In part A, all your first year, second year and third year subjects are included except oral pathology. Means all anatomy, embryo, histo, then physio, biochem, all the other medical subjects are included in part one. Each subject has 14 marks and all your dental clinical subjects are included in part B. Each subject has 14 marks. So you cannot underestimate any subject here and the grand total is 214. So I think it's all about, I have covered all about this exam pattern, their qualification criteria, syllabus and marking scheme. If you have any doubt, you can ask me the questions. William Shakespeare has said that do it today or regret it tomorrow. Means three things you need for success are no more than others, work more than others, and expect more than others. So thank you so much and all the best for your exam. Do the best. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.
Yes, thank you. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Sneha, for such a crisp presentation. I would like to tell the students that Dr. Sneha, Dr. Rutuja and Dr. Shruti, they have divided the topics amongst themselves. This was the first part of it.
Yes, sir.
You can ask the questions in either the question answer box or in the chat box. I'll read it out for you. And you can put your names as well, no problem. Sneha Madam, there is one question.
Yes, sir.
What is the right time to start preparing for NEET PG?
Yes, sir. I already told the answer. It's better, always better late than never. So I think the students are now in second year or third year, they can start think in that direction. Means they have so many means MCQ books are available. So and in the university pattern also there are 20 marks for I think for MCQs. At my time there were 20 marks for MCQ. So I was when I was in second year, at my time, I was preparing for MCQ also from the MCQ books and solving those MCQs questions. So that it, I think it will help you in entrance exam. But when you are in the suppose you are in second year or third year, you should think in that direction ki you have to do a master in dental surgery after completing the final year. So, and if you are in final year, completed the final year and now in internship, then I think you should start your preparation in just in this month only. Means the starting of the internship only, because this is the most precious time you have for preparation.
That means everyone should start rather they shouldn't start preparing, they should never stop preparing for
yes, sir.
So it is not like that you ignore all 4 years and start preparing during internship. It is also not like that, right?
Right.
Yeah. Okay, there is second right. question. Okay, and I would like to tell all the students that we can have
yes,
some of the answers we will get maybe in a few next lectures also. Huh? Best classes to prepare and online tests. So best online tests and best classes to prepare. Can you suggest? This is another question.
Okay. So frankly speaking, I never joined any private class, but I joined some pre-planner series at my time. So it helped me a lot because they were giving 5 questions per day, 5 different questions means related to figures, some related to any means like to any subjects. They have decided the subject, and in that subject they were giving me the 5 questions. But I think it's also good, but I don't think so. You should means it's my advice ki you should go for any private class. Our college is also, I think, are taking the mock test. So it's good enough to go for these tests, and because this private class or any private classes like Target or anything like DMS or anything, they are preparing their own timetable, and you have to go according to their timetable. So you do not have any freedom to prepare to go to as per your pace or as per your direction. So I feel ki it's better to do your own study, take the guidance from other people who have already done those things, and I feel it's good enough to get a good score in the exam.
Yeah. Even my observation throughout these 20 years is that all the students who had got good ranks in entrance exams were never associated with any particular class. In fact, they followed their own instincts. Third question is, can you please suggest any website or academic academies for mock tests?
Okay, I think, sir, our college is taking this test.
Yes, we will be taking.
Yeah.
One question.
I think there is app is available. NEET MDS preparation app is there. You can download that app, and there are so many subject wise questions are available there.
And. Okay, and again the same question, there is one more, that is it necessary to join any coaching institute for NEET PG preparation? So it's the same question.
Yeah.
Is there separate exam for armed forces medical or dental college, and how to get into armed forces?
No, there is no separate exam. At the time of filling the application form for NEET MDS, there is one option ki you would you like to opt for Armed Force Institute. Then if you tick that core, tick that bracket, then box, then they will give you the options regarding in which institutes if you are interested in. Means you have to opt that box at the time of form filling.
That's all. These were the questions.
Okay.
What kind of exams are there to study MDS abroad? Prachiti, I think this question will not be related to today's lecture. Although we have not displayed the timetable, but
okay.
we will soon be having a program, maybe in Jan's second week or third week, which will tell us about the options abroad. So
yes,
Prachiti's question will be replied in those sessions.
Yes.
Yes. Now this is a good question. In fact, I was waiting for this question. Which books we should study for entrance exam preparation?
Sorry, sir. I'm not able.
Which books?
Sorry, sir. I'm not.
Okay. Which books should be used for MDS exam preparation? MDS entrance exam preparation, I mean.
Okay. Yeah. So many people ask me this question because means they have a doubt. Means first to prepare means MCQ book we should solve first or we should read the textbooks first. But I think you should go for MCQ books first because you have to give the questions, means you have to apply for the questions in the objective format. So you have already have done the textbooks or read the textbooks or all your 8 subjects and other medical subjects. If you are in any doubt, you can obviously go to the textbook, clear your concept and further go to the MCQ book. But there are so many MCQ books are available. Dental Pulse is there. Neeraj Vadhwan is there. It's for AIPG, means when it was conducted before my time. So all the questions paper are there. All the questions paper of AIPG are there in the Neeraj Vadhwan book. And this topic also going to be conducted by Dr. Shruti in further lecture.
Thank you very much, Dr.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I hope this session will give a fair idea about the various exams for all our students, available for our students. And in future also, we will keep in touch with you. If required, we will ask for some more time from you.
Yes, sir. Maybe sure.
Topic.
Yes, sir. Sure.
And all the students, I mean, who have any other question, can please inform us. We can ask Dr. Sneha and we'll surely get the answer. So thank you very much, everyone, for attending the session. And thank you, Dr. Sneha, for sparing the time. And it is very difficult for one to prepare such a presentation. I know how it is at GDC. You know,
yes.
All these wanted candidates, staff members, and students, you won't be able to imagine how much loaded they are with patients. I request, I mean, all of you to once at least visit the departments and how those PGs are working. So thanks a lot.
Yes, sir. It's my pleasure.
I can see one more question here.
Yes.
Yash is asking, we have many books for one particular subject, like we have Shanbag and Tripathi for Pharmac, and so on. Now, which book precisely to prefer?
Okay. The authentic books are there in Tripathi for pharmacology and other textbooks. Means there are lot of textbooks which are authentic that we should read only. Like for conservative dentistry, we have Studevant, but we never read it in our second year or third year or final year. But I think you should always go through the standard textbook before rather than going to the shortcuts. This will be my advice. Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much, everyone, and thank you, Dr. Sneha.
Yes, sir.
The next session for the students will be on 25th morning, 9:00. And the third one will be on 27th, Sunday, 9:00 in the morning. I'll end the webinar.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
See you.
Yes. Yes. Sir.